Our conference is about sex and its symbolism in the rock art of the Zezer, Acera and Alva Rivers, Portugal, a form of language. Human representation is probably one of the most exciting themes in rock art iconography. The area studied by APIA, Portuguese Association of Archaeological Investigation, since 1998, and by its Rock Art Interpretation Center in Vide, is delimited by the two hydrographical basins of the Serra and Alva rivers, in the very mountainous region of the Serra do Açor and the Serra da Estrela, in the interior of the Portugal. More than 1,000 slabs with rock art engravings were discovered in the course of the various research projects. The engravings are mostly found on the smooth surfaces and schist slabs, and their chronology ranges from the Neolithic to the Iron Age and until modern times. According to our scientific approach and the methodology adopted, 11 large areas or concentration of rock art sites were defined. The localization of rock art sites follows a pattern worth stressing. They appear on mountain ridges or the slopes. In the later situation, they always seem to be isolated slabs, overlooking water courses and with great visual amplitude, predominantly oriented along northwest southeast axis. They were probably associated with astronomical observations. In this image, a diagram of the distribution podomorphs azimuth in the River Serra and the Alva basins. The other type of localization of sites is along mountain ridges, almost always associated with pathways. These ridges were real natural routes and lines of passage for wild animals as well as people, and were used as transmass routes until the 20th century. On these locations, we find hundreds of engraved slabs, but almost always with fewer engravings and with less overlapping. The human figure appears in both cases. The analysis undertaken revealed 29 different typologies of anthropomorphic representation. These appear 184 engravings. The majority are male representation due to their phallic characteristics. Anthropomorphs cruciforms with a triangular body and horns, a shaman with a form and circle with a movement, form a circle without movement, associated with a horse, a shape of E, associated with animal traction, vehicle, with a frame, praying, a rectangular, complex, with open hands, with a shield, with arms, open hands, and bowed legs. Open arms and bowed legs in motion, associated with arch, stilled with open legs, with head, forms sexual and ejaculation, globular with navel, star-shaped, hybrid, incomplete, with horns and in the profile, with horns hybrid, horns mask, with antennas close on the hands and the feet, holding a snake. In this slide, we have a typology of podomorphs existing in the region of the River Serra and Alva, Portugal. And the other image is a type of anthropomorph, phallic anthropomorph, with same podomorphs and oblong circles. In the other site, number 209, Casa dos Mouros, there may be an evidence for the need to represent the smaller members of the community or the family. This preoccupation with leaving marks on a particular spot may reflect the intention of sacralizing the place to ensure the continuation and the renovation of this species, since it may be linked to fertility. The engraved slabs found in this kind of context are almost always richer in terms of quantity of engravings and motifs, and show more chronological phases of engravings and overlapping. In the left image, anthropomorph, and the right side, the Casa dos Mouros. Anthropomorphic figure appear associated with podomorphs, adults and the small ones, perhaps newborn, as for example on sites in the area of Vid, Fontes de Cid. In the right side, a small podomorph. In the same image, we have big podomorphs and small podomorphs with anthropomorphs in the center of the image. Of the 29 different classified types of anthropomorphic figures, some stand out as being quite complex and rich in its symbolism. These were mainly found in the Vide and the Ribeira do Alvo areas, associated with bows and at Fonte de Ouro and the shields at the site of Carvalheiros Abelheira, in the right side. The example of acephalous anthropomorphic detail and bow representation in the center of the image, a spiral in the top of this image. In the Vide and the Ribeira do Alvo area, anthropomorphs associated with arches present engraving technique, abrasion, throat rotation, very sharp art, percussion, incision, and hammering. A great number of cruciform elements were also noted, and these, in certain cases, include anthropomorphic ones. Example, this site, they have many cruciforms, different types of cruciforms, with frames, same. Please, Annabella, continue. Yes, yes. Passar para aqui.
Here we have possible representations of chamas. We call it orantes, with open hands and raised arms, and others with different variations, engravings with horns, triangle body, and association with wheels and animal draw. Engravings with horns, here associated with podomorphs and oblong circles, as it's common in these swaps. Here we have more with oblong circles associated to different types of podomorphs, with frames and without, and simple podomorphs, the type of cruciform type, or associated with animals like an equite, with a helmet or a hat, with open arms and a bow act, rectangular, with phalluses, with antennas, claws on the hands and feet, and holding a snake. These engravings represent thousands of years of occupation and probably spirituality. In an ancient natural way, there is a cyst panel with several engravings, highlighting the anthropomorphs with open arms and hands, possible praying together with anthropomorphs of undetermined gender associated with shields and weapons. In this web has several levels covered with 189 cup marks. It has three levels existing at the base of the representation, the lower level, anthropomorphic and vulviforms. May represent a kind of ascetic path with men represented at the base of this cosmology. Here we have one of the most important sites called Ferraduras. The site of Ferraduras was considered to have a female anthropomorph, the only one in our sites, due to its morphological characteristics, the presence of a cup mark in place of the sex of the figure. To be noted, this is the fact that this female anthropomorphic figure is linked to a male one. The two possible represent a genital pair. We have here more phallic anthropomorphics with frames, three different types. Here, another type, the rectangular and complex anthropomorphic figures. This web has the engravings of six horseshoes, five with each and one without, nine anthropomorphs appearing either as a cruciform with a bow above them or with arms in the air and legs spread. Three figures that are interpreted here as animal cars, animal draw, bow, a cruciform, four cup marks, a segment, rectangular, and seven indeterminate engravings. In Pedras Lavadas Mountain, we have anthropomorphs in prayer. They have a kind of a hat that can be related to solar rituals. As conclusion, the iconographic representations of anthropomorphic figures in the rock art of the Serra and Alba rivers serve as an important source of information in the understanding of prehistoric and protohistoric of this part of the Iberian Peninsula. Male's engravings of the Bronze Rock Age are identified by their phallus and also by the presence of attributes such as male weaponry, swords, axes, shields, and spears, or as hunters with a bow and arrow, or as farmers plowing the field. To determine female sexual characteristics are breasts, vulva, a cup mark, a dot, circle, oval, or shoe shape. Women figures are defined on the basis of biological sex, while men are also defined on the basis of their activities. So, what is the message left on the swaps? Certainly indicates the presence of hundreds of groups near major natural routes or on transhumance routes. The engravings may define routes and be a territorial issue, stopping places, but we believe that part of the swaps has a ritual character, a language associated with fertile quotes, prayers for good luck during the transhumance routes, and old-time rituals like the passage from trinage to men. Rock art is clearly a way of immortalizing a message. It is therefore a proto-language and a proto-writing. Thank you.